I'm as excited, I think, as anybody with the recent release of 2020.24.6.1. It is, I think, Tesla's best update for the features that I want to use that's come out in a long time, certainly this year. But one feature that hasn't gotten enough discussion, I think, is the option to activate the cabin camera. Part of the problem is, I think, some people have jumped the gun as far as interpreting how that this will be helpful to a driver. But right now, you read what Tesla says that they're going to use the cabin camera for, and it's not for you, it's for them. And that opens up a lot of issues that I think you need to consider before agreeing to activate that camera. Now, I know you could read for yourself, but in this case, reading the description is a big part of what I'm trying to get people to do. It starts out, help Tesla continue to develop safer vehicles by sharing camera data from your vehicle. Straight out, first two words, help Tesla. This is about helping them, not helping you. At face value, I'm all for helping Tesla to develop safer vehicles by sharing a lot of data, but I don't want to share my in-camera video feed with them, and here's why. If enabled, Tesla will automatically capture images and a short video clip just prior to a collision or safety event to help engineers develop safety features and enhancements in the future. What does that really mean? First of all, we know what a collision is, but what are those safety events that Tesla describes? They don't say. I think some people have interpreted that it's gonna get recorded in sensor cam somehow, or you as a Tesla owner will have access to that video somehow. That's not what this is. In fact, the last part of this is very telling, and it has to do with where they placed your permission to use this. It is under safety and security data sharing, as in the different permissions that you give Tesla to collect data about you, how you're driving your car, what your car is doing. You can see, I actually have the two previous options selected as yes, because I want to help Tesla make this car better, make future cars safer, based upon some anonymized data about how I'm using this car. You cannot anonymize your face. You cannot anonymize the faces of your family. Facial recognition technology is ubiquitous. It is everywhere. If someone has an image of your face, in an instant, they're gonna know exactly who you are and every bit of data that's associated with your name. This isn't tinfoil hat stuff. This is the real deal about sharing pictures on the internet that you need to be aware of. Except in-cabin video isn't just sharing your picture of you in your car. It's linking you specifically to things you do prior to an accident. Not only that, we don't know what a short video clip is. How long is a short video clip? Is it 10 minutes like is recorded when you save a file on Tesla Cam? But let's talk about Tesla Cam for a minute, because that's going to illustrate the problem that I see with enabling Tesla to have access to the cabin camera. As you probably already know, Tesla Cam is active in the background as long as you have a properly formatted drive connected to the car. You can turn it on, you can turn it off manually even with the drive connected, but as long as you can see this icon with the red dot, it means that Tesla Cam is recording in the background. But you don't have access to that data unless you hit save footage. And at that point, it's going to save the past 10 minutes of video footage to your drive. What's going on in the meantime? Well, obviously that video data is being buffered somewhere, but increasingly Tesla itself isn't even allowing people to have access to that buffer in the event of somebody having a collision and in the heat of the moment forgetting to hit record. The other thing is, as long as your car is on, it could be overwriting that buffer, so you don't know what that data is going to end up with. But why does Tesla make you hit record for the last 10 minutes when you could put a gigantic drive in and just have, like a lot of motorcyclists do with their GoPros, you can have a loop recording is what it's called, so that it's always riding over the oldest footage until you want to actually preview it. And then you just eject the drive and you might have hours and hours of footage there. Technically, that is feasible. Tesla doesn't do that. There's a very important reason why. If you are in an accident, you have to make this choice. There is a camera system, but you might actually be at fault, and you might not want to share video of that accident with anybody at that point. If this were always recording and that evidence were available to you, you'd have to turn it over. That is the law. Worse still, if you knew that evidence were available to you and then you destroyed it, or you hid the drive or something like that, you're probably committing a felony in most jurisdictions of destroying evidence. The way TeslaCam works is a really smart way to get around that, because you only have that video evidence recorded if, after the fact, you take an action to record it. The law can't compel you to hit that save button. The law does compel you to not destroy evidence that's already been saved. So if you're in an accident and you're at fault, you have the option of not recording the evidence against you. Understand, I am not making a moral statement about any of this. That's up for you to decide what you want to do in that situation. But you do need to understand the legal peril that you would be in if you record the evidence of you being at fault at an accident. But as stated, the way TeslaCam works, you have the very legal option of not actually recording that evidence that could be used against you. You could decide, you know what? I don't want this video. I don't want to save this video. Let's go back to the cabin camera analytics. If you select yes, that's out the window, because it tells you you're in a collision or you have some other whatever a safety event is. Video of you and everybody in the car could be sent to Tesla for their use. How are they going to use it? We don't know, but I know one certain way that we're going to see them use it in the future. Anytime Tesla is blamed for an accident, mainly because somebody's saying, well, autopilot did that, or the person was on autopilot and autopilot didn't save them, Tesla goes to the log and they share that log publicly. This person didn't have their hand on the wheel for this amount of time, or right before the accident, or things like that. Part of the problem that I have with that is that's not actually what the data can tell Tesla. It can only tell Tesla that they're not putting enough torque on the wheel for their hand to be sensed. That's all it can say. And even I, as somebody who always drives with my hand on the wheel, will occasionally get reminders because I'm not putting enough torque for the car to know that my hand is there. So right there, we already know that Tesla is willing to frame the data against the best interests of the driver and for their own best interests. Now let's add another layer. Let's add what you're doing in the car prior to a collision. You very well may be at fault. You might have been distracted by a particularly compelling or interesting billboard. You might have seen a car that you lust after and your attention was drawn away from the road. You might be yelling at your kids in the back seat. It could be a lot of different things that suggest that you're at fault, even if you're not. And Tesla's not only going to have that data, they're going to probably share it publicly. I don't know if they're going to share the actual video, but they will certainly say, review of the video data shows that the person's attention was not on the road. Now, again, I'm not arguing about the morals of whether or not you being at fault is something you want the world to know. That's fine if that's the kind of person you are. But you might not even be at fault, and any data recorded at the time of a collision, it's going to be used to defend Tesla. It's not going to be used to promote whatever you're trying to get out of the data. To protect your privacy, cabin camera images and video clips will not be associated with your vehicle identification number. I'll believe it when I see it. I'll believe that this is something that we should let Tesla have access to when I see what they're actually doing with this data. My recommendation to everybody is to say no, at least for now. The liability that this creates is tremendous. The privacy issues that it could create if this data falls into the wrong hands could be pretty significant. The gain to any one of us as an individual for saying yes is very low, but the risk at best is completely unknowable. I'm a pretty risk-averse person. That's why I own a Tesla in the first place. This is still the safest car ever tested by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. I fully believe that autopilot plus me is safer than just me driving alone. But that risk aversion, that desire to find the safest way through things, is why I'm not going to allow Tesla to collect this data. This is to help Tesla. It's not to help you. At this point, when Tesla is helping itself, we don't really know if that means that the data might harm you. I don't mean physically, but I mean harm your case against Tesla if you bring one, harm your case in defending yourself against law enforcement action, or I don't know what. Anything where video of what you're doing inside the car might be used against you. What I think most people were really hoping this was going to be, and some people have actually been reporting it incorrectly as such, is that activating the in-cabin camera will allow Sentry mode to record things like somebody breaking into your car. The other option might be for rideshare drivers being able to record something that their passengers end up doing that they want to be able to share either with law enforcement or YouTube or whatever for their benefit. Those are all going to be great reasons to activate the in-cabin camera. There will still be risks involved in activating that camera for Sentry mode or as a rideshare driver, but at least there's the opportunity that's going to have a big benefit to the individual that activates it. Until we know more about how Tesla is going to use this data, until we know more about what the risks are of this data being out there about you, I recommend that you do not allow Tesla to record this data. It takes some serious mental gymnastics on my part to see how engineers are going to use data of me in the car to actually make a big improvement that I as an individual will ever be able to experience. I think that's a stretch. Tesla could certainly allay a lot of concerns by explaining what a security event is, describing how many photos are actually taken, describing what a short video clip is, describing exactly the kinds of situations that engineers will pull this data to make things better the way they say they're going to make them. You shouldn't agree to allow Tesla to have video of you before an accident. And all of your passengers too, you're agreeing for everybody that's in your vehicle when you don't have access to that information yourself. The benefits are way out of balance. If you found this video researching Teslas and you actually made it this far, be sure to use my referral link to order your Tesla. You can see it right here. It'll get you free supercharging. Full details about the Tesla Owners Referral Program can be found at the link. Be sure to subscribe for more videos on Tesla updates and whether or not you should actually use the features. I really appreciate you watching The Tech of Tech, and hope to see you next time.